Howie's literally singing in my ear right now, and it's awful. It's hard. You guys don't even know. You don't want to even know what that sounds like. It's awful. It's like glass piercing my eardrums, cutting them and shredding them and making them bleed. Guys, what's up? This is David Morgan. Mercy, mercy. You guys want to hear a great sax player? Cannonball Adderley, man. Just sublime. Check him out today. That's what you should do, okay? My name's David. This is The Music Shed, and we are cleaning out the shed from 2004, January 26th, to be exact. It came out. Ed, Mitch, Troy, and Brian. And the band is called Crossfade. And the song is called Cold. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the bell icon for notifications, and leave comments. And never heard of these guys. Heard of Crossroads. And I know what a crossfade is. It's a recording editing tool, crossfading. What they used to do is, I'm not going to explain it. It's really boring. But most of the songs that you hear have many crossfades in them, especially these days, because they're a lot easier, because the digital world is not easier than the music could do in cutting tape. It's like a digit. It's really, really simple. So crossfading is a thing. And I don't know, I'm feeling really weird right now. So let's just listen to Cold by Crossfade. Let's check it out. Never heard this before. I promise, swear, you guys. Okay. I can tell this isn't live. These guys are horrible actors.
Looking back at me, I see that I never really got it right. I never stopped to think of you. I'm always wrapped up in things I cannot win. You are the antidote that gets me by. Something strong like a drug that gets me.
So that, like, D minor, B flat. Great, fun thing to play on. And since chords aren't copyrightable, just use that chord progression and write your own song, if you're so inclined. Enough of that.
Really meant to say is I'm sorry for the way I am. I never meant to be so cold. Never meant to be so cold. I really meant to say is I'm sorry for the way
Mohawk. Cold, being cold and lying. Like, why do we do that? Why do we do those things? Is it because we're human? Do human beings have to do that to each other? Is that a thing that needs to happen? Do we have to be cold and distant? And do we have to lie and manipulate all that stuff? I mean, I'd say we don't have to do those things. And certainly I've done it. I'm guilty myself. I'm not saying that I don't. But we as a species, like, why? Why do we do that? What's up with us?
Maybe in a different light, you could see me stand on my own again. Cause now I can see you are the antidote that got me by. Something strong like a drug that got me.
Okay, I'm going to make a lot of emotional commentary here. See, what happens is these people get together and stop what you're doing right now because you need to hear this because this is about you today. People get together and it's like this hot, amazing thing and you're like making out and you have sex and like you're all into each other. It's amazing. And then everything in life, the newness wears off. It always does. whether you get a new car or a new boyfriend or girlfriend, or you have a new friend, or you a new job, everything that's new, the luster and the sheen wears off and reality sets in. And you got to deal with loving someone in that place when all that first honeymoon stuff goes away, which it will. Not that you don't get it back sometimes. You do, totally. But you got to learn to love each other and be there for each other in when that all that initial stuff wears off. That's where the rubber hits the road. And we don't know how to do that. We as a society don't know how to do that. We don't. And a lot of people end up getting really hurt. It's a problem. Now, I'm not like, you know, am I getting on a soapbox? Yeah, maybe. I don't know why this video particularly is hitting me in this way. But that's what I'm feeling. And it's my channel. I'll do whatever I want. But it's a problem, I think. Is it a problem for you? Let me know. Well, if you never meant to do it, then don't do it. I'm really ragging on these guys. But I'm not ragging on them. I'm ragging on people in general who can't stop doing this. You know what I mean? Like, if you didn't mean to do it, okay, say you're sorry once and then don't do it anymore. Try to figure out a way to... Am I being like Dr. Phil today? Or like Oprah? Is that what I'm doing? Maybe it is. Maybe someone out there needs to hear this though. I don't know. I'm shaking my finger like I know best. I really don't.
To be so cold.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Nice guitar solo.
I never really wanted you to see.
Whoa. Nice drum fill. You know, so I'm going to keep going on this. I'm just on a roll here. If you know that you're cold and you know that you don't want to be that way to someone that you care about, don't we have to plan like things to do and talk to them and be empathic and be vulnerable and, you know, buy flowers or a present or just do nice things? Like, you got to be proactive in this stuff, because that initial spark that you've got can keep going in a much deeper way. I found, you know, I've been married for 28 years. It's a long time. And when we are working on our marriage and we're working on our relationship and we're talking and we're communicating and we're really working at it, things are usually, we're closer and we're more connected and attracted to each other. And when we're not, we're not. And we can both, you know, Liz and I can both be like that. So this has turned into really like a total Oprah episode. You know what? What the fuck? Like, who cares? Like, I hope you guys are getting some out of this, because I really mean this stuff. Gone, dude. Yeah, that's. I just think that's a really bad excuse. I never meant to be so cold. Like, you know. So, that song led me to a lot of just from the heart stuff to you guys today about relationships. They always lose their luster, the initial luster, and they always take work. Now, what I've found too, the good news is that if you do the work and if you try and if you are conscientious about your relationship, that initial honeymoon luster stuff can happen even deeper because then you're putting in the work to get it. Do you know what I mean? I just know it from experience. You know, so, but I think that what happens is, and I think the tragedy of our times is that people think that initial thing, if it fades, then the relationship is not meant to be. But that's not fucking true. That's not true at all. And that's why the divorce rate is like 60%. Because we selfishly want it to just make us feel good. But that's not what it's about. So this was not about the music very much at all. It was about something else. So whatever. It is what it is. So if you enjoyed it, great. If you want me to just, you know, if you don't, let me know in the comments what you think. Don't forget to like and subscribe, hit the bell icon, leave comments, and yeah, Crossfade Cold put me on a little tirade today. I own it. And just, you know, if you don't mean to do it, just don't do it. Stop yourself. Have some self-control. Get your shit together. And treat people well. Do unto others, man. Music, peace, love. Later.